Hello everybody, my name is Vinay Jacob John. Please visit my gospel website jesushealsministries.org. Today we're going to read from the Holy Bible about how the Holy Spirit came down from heaven when Peter, the apostle, and the other apostles and the disciples were gathered together in the upper room praying that the Holy Spirit would come down from heaven. The prophecy is in Joel 2 and the prophecy is fulfilled in Acts 2. Joel 2 is in the Old Testament and Acts 2 is in the New Testament. Joel chapter 2, verse 28. And it shall come to pass afterward, I will pour out my Holy Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions. And upon the servants and upon the handmaids, in those days will I pour out my Holy Spirit. And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The earth, the sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and the terrible day of the Lord Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit, Jesus comes. And it shall come to pass, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion is God's throne room, and in Jerusalem is God's holy city, shall be deliverance, as the Lord Jehovah Jesus Holy Spirit Jehovah has said, and in the remnant whom the Lord Jehovah Jesus Holy Spirit Jehovah shall call. And also Acts chapter 2, verse 14. Peter, standing up with the 11 apostles, lifted up his voice and said unto them, Ye men of Judea and all that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you and hearken to my words. Verse 16. This is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel 2. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, I will pour out of my Holy Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my Holy Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show on one, and they will prophesy means they will pray in tongues and interpret what they are saying in tongues. Tongues plus interpretation equals prophecy. You are the prophet of your own life. When you speak in tongues and you get an interpretation from Jesus, you are doing the will of Jesus, because Jesus will tell you what to do. What Jesus says we will do, what Jesus sends us, we will go. In your name, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Verse 16. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. Verse 17. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my Holy Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens I will pour out in those days of my Holy Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before that great and notable day of the Lord Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, Jesus comes. And it shall come to pass, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth shall be saved. Acts chapter 2 verses 1 to 4. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord, purpose of mind, in one place. Apostle Peter and the other apostles were gathered with the disciples in the upper room, praying that the Holy Spirit would come down from heaven to earth in Jerusalem, Israel, 2000 years ago. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak with other tongues and interpret and prophesy as the Holy Spirit gave them utterance. Thanks for listening to me today. Jesus loves us all. Jesus heals us all. Jesus provides for us all. Always. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.